No more pornography. Let's develop Indonesia with dignity.
It is absolutely necessary that we take action against pornography, and a law against pornography must be created.
Public outcry on a national scale is understandable because women and children are the main victims of pornography. In 2006, research carried out by the Indonesian Science and Research Institute revealed that Indonesia has now overtaken Russia as having the most widespread distribution of child pornography.
Indonesia ini berbeda dengan misalnya di negara barat di mana
pornografi. Unlike in many Western countries where pornography is restricted to adults and the distribution and sale of the material is carried out discreetly and away from children, in Indonesia it is sold openly everywhere, at roadsides, at railway stations, and even in front of our schools.
Cukup bebas.
A recent survey by the Institute of Yayasan Kita dan Buah Hati showed that more than 80% of children aged 8 to 12 had access to pornography and linked this to its easy availability.
After a child has watched porn once, he'll be inclined to watch even stronger material, and after that will surely be more inclined to act out what he's watched, because his limbic system, which controls his emotions, is linked to his immature cerebral cortex, which is responsible for thought and reasoning.
What psychologists explain is not just theory, but reality. Dede is an adolescent who has become a victim of the free circulation of pornography in Indonesia. As a result of this exposure, he became a sexual offender.
When I was asleep, I would always be dreaming of it, also during lessons in school. Like wanting to smoke when you've given up, you feel like something's missing. Before, when I wasn't watching porn, I would always feel something was missing.
But Zainal's crime was even worse than Dede's. He has spent the last 10 years in prison for raping and killing a 12-year-old girl.
I saw a girl playing alone, and I wanted to have sex with her because I often used to watch porno films at home. I raped her. As I was raping her, she struggled. And then I saw a stone lying beside her. I picked it up, and I hit her head with the stone, and she lost consciousness.
To hide the evidence, the boy set fire to the girl's body.
Yes, I burned her body with kerosene to hide what I had done.
In 2005, the National Commission for the Protection of Children reported that at least 41% of cases of sexual aggression against children were actually rape. The Women's Congress of Indonesia, together with non-government organizations, have been campaigning since 1998 for proper regulation of pornography in the country, but with limited success. Campaigners want the present legislation to be strengthened to protect the weak and to provide rehabilitation so that perpetrators do not re-offend.
The public must stand together and show, through religious education, reproductive health education, and sex education, that pornography is not something children should have access to.
When I pray, I weep when I remember my sins. Against my parents and against my victim. She never did anything against me, so why did I kill her?
Regret often comes too late, but if we can protect ourselves and our families against the dangers of pornography, then at the very least, we will be able to prevent more serious incidents and more regrets.